COVID-19 is back with a vengeance. We've experienced the worst number of cases twice this week, and now we're going under some of the strictest measures to quell the virus. It's time to do your part, Guam. I'm Tyler Matanani, and here is your trend spotting report.
The numbers tell a story. Community spread. We began the week with some of the worst numbers we had ever seen. 42 reported just on Monday, but that was just a hint of what was to come. Over the weekend, the governor rolled the island back into P-Corps 1 after a COVID count continued its upward trend. Non-essential businesses shuttered again and we were forced back into lockdown. On Tuesday, there were another 19 cases reported, then 22. Then on Thursday, the governor called for a press conference to announce more devastating news. Guam suffered its sixth COVID-19-related death. That morning, a 70-year-old man was taken to the hospital and pronounced dead on arrival. According to the Joint Information Center, the man wasn't a known COVID-19 case, but he did have underlying health conditions. He was swabbed at GMH and was found to be positive for the virus. The rising numbers and new death put officials on alert. Governor Lou Leon-Guerrero and her team, including hospital administrator Lillian Posadas, were very much concerned about hospital capacity. Posadas also said patients were coming in much more critically ill, requiring oxygen and ventilators. The governor even stressed that despite what you might think of who's affected by the virus, Guam is seeing lots of younger people infected, even those seeking critical care. For sure, Thursday afternoon, we were all shook by the death as we waited to hear of the next set of numbers to return from public health. The lab, however, is swamped with tests piling from community outreach as well as private clinics. Officials all said the report would be late on Thursday. Public health was behind by some 1,500 samples, which they say were safely refrigerated. And we waited till the end of the day as rumors spread of triple digits. Sadly, the rumors were true. The governor made the announcement via social media. 105 positive cases out of 962 samples. It's prompted her to take drastic measures, closing all businesses except for grocery stores, healthcare services, and other life-preserving operations. Let's take a breath here and look at some of your thoughts on this. Larry DeHelig says, please stop all the negative comments. Take a moment to pray. This is not the time to start pointing fingers. Do as what we've been told to do. Stay indoors. Just saying. Be safe and take care, Guam. Kinnette Kamtai also says, great decision, Governor. Our frontliners are getting hit from COVID-19. And Ruth Pablo Gagnon adds, not looking good, Guam. Shouldn't have gone this far if people had adhered to mandates from day one. And looking at one of our Instagram comments from the Peter Rivera, he says, this will never end because we don't have control of all the people that are positive. Are they really staying at home? And if they are, everyone in that household needs to stay home as a precaution. Shelter in place, lockdown, but yet the same things will still be open as now? What's the difference? Amidst all this heavy information, there was a hot spotlight cast on Guam thanks to the talent of Brian Esperon. The choreographer is the hottest thing on TikTok right now, breaking it down to the WAP by Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion. Esperon was backed by the crew from Skip, including KUAM alum Cami Aguirola. The great Cardi B herself even went live trying to learn Esperon's dance. Don't forget to check out my interview on In the Mix this week with Brian. And maybe you can learn the WAP while we're all under lockdown. Check out the comment from Cardi herself. My back hurt watching it. Let me try it.
Hopefully, you're going to protect yourself to protect all of us. That means staying at home by any means, keeping those masks on, and when you do go out, make sure to keep your distance. And now we wait. Until next week, stay safe, Guahan. Adios.